Welcome to Mediocre Gaming, and today we're playing Tom Clancy's The Division. Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and salutations. Today, it's fantastic. Let's get to it. The Fang Shield is now available, and what do you need to do in order to get it? Now, as you're getting these shields, you unlock certain things. Currently for the current game in Division, but you also unlock some cosmetics in the Division 2 for completing certain number of shields. So completing one shield will get you something, completing four shields will get you the next tier, completing eight will unlock the third tier, and then completing all 12 will get you all of the new cosmetics. So what do we need to do? We need to do and complete each legendary mission, so all seven legendary missions.
You'll need to get inside.
Now, how do we do that?
The link, notebooks, hard drives,
whatever. I'm going to be showing you the Amherst legendary mission.
The cleaners are on their way to sterilize the place.
Now, this does apply to all the legendary missions. Now, when you're looking at the Amherst Department 1, you can tell that there are the encounters, some of them are the same as in regular missions, legendary missions, the enemies are much more difficult, and you usually have some encounters in different places, and the encounters work a little bit differently. So if you have a pre-made group of four, this should go pretty smoothly for you. If you do not, then you can go into matchmaking and get a team of four. Highly recommended. Could you do it by yourself? Certainly, but it is going to take you a lot longer to do, or should. Now, once you get your team of four, you need to complement your skills. You need to have 1 to 2 tanky DPS, like defense, like a 9,000 stamina striker, and sometimes that works and sometimes that doesn't, or Predator's Mark, something that has a lot of stamina, a lot of hit points, in order to soak up some of that damage. Okay, what else? You're gonna want one dedicated healer. If there's one position that you cannot overlook, it is the dedicated healer. So someone like Reclaimer, Firecrest, or another electronics-based or skill-based set. Final Measure can be if you're using that, but Reclaimer is one of the best ones to use. Finally, you're going to want 1 to 2 DPS or debuff. So if you have someone using Sentry's Call or someone using a firearms-based set, then that will work pretty well. So you want one healer, one tank, possibly two tanks, and a DPS or two, depending on whether or not you have one tank or two. So once you have it set up, go into it, and when you go into it, you're going to want to go in more cautiously than you do most other missions. Unlike other missions, you cannot face tank these guys. They will burn you down. Even if you have 10,000 stamina and a full stack on a striker, they will still burn you down. So the best thing to do is to ensure that you're using cover. Make sure that whoever they are focused on, that the other people are doing damage. If you are or have someone in your group that is using Reclaimer, have that support box down all the time, if at all possible. If they don't destroy it, there will be a cooldown. Hopefully you have skill haste in there in order to get that box back quickly. Now, additionally, if you're using if you're the healer, or if the person that you know is being the dedicated healer, I do recommend the other skill to be a pulse. Now, unless you're using Firecrest. Firecrest, obviously you're going to have a flame turret. Everyone else have a pulse, because when you have a 9,000 electronics skill-based character. That pulse turns into a mega pulse that's going to max out your crit chance and increase your crit damage by a huge percentage. So all of a sudden you're going to be able to melt those enemies very quickly, whether you're skill based or firearms based or stamina based, just based on the amount of crit damage you're going to be doing to them. So I do recommend that. Is it necessary? No, but it's not really necessary to have a support station, but it really, really helps out. Alright, so based on the composition of your team, you may want to go in with a couple of sets of gear on you so that you can switch it up, because it doesn't make a lot of sense to have two players with Predator's Mark. Doesn't have make a lot of sense to have multiple Reclaimers, multiple Final Measures, etc. So if you already have someone in your team that's using Predator's Mark, you probably want to switch to something else, even if it's a Striker. If you do not have a dedicated healer, switch out to a electronics-based set so that you can fill that role of the dedicated healer. And if you're not using Reclaimer, or you don't have a Reclaimer, then you may have to use two healing skills, or both of the healing skills. And I do recommend all four characters use Recovery Link. Recovery Link is very useful if you've got two or three players down. And if that other player doesn't have Recovery Link, how are they going to bring everyone else back up quickly? Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to ring the bell before you leave to be notified of all future episodes as soon as they go live. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And we'll see you next time.